the one thing we didn't address in there was why we want a tax cut now when we have an economy running faster than its potential and unemployment so low. What's the benefit right now?
So it's not so much about cutting taxes. It's not trying to stimulate demand by that. It's trying to improve where capital gets used in the economy and where it gets used in the world. And we have a tax system now that discourages capital coming into the business sector, that it discourages capital coming to the United States, because our tax rate, our corporate tax rate, is higher than the tax rate of other industrial countries. And the way we tax the subsidiaries, the foreign subsidiaries of U.S. corporations, causes them to leave their funds outside the U.S. rather than bringing it back home to invest here.
Well, how do we know it will be used for productive uses, growing the economy, as opposed to going to shareholders in the form of dividends or buybacks?
Even if it goes to shareholders in the form of dividends and buybacks, they're not going to rush out to consume more. Simply, they will use those funds to, they will save those funds, they will use them to invest in other companies.
If they do bring the money back on a deemed repatriation from overseas, much of the money in 2004 went into dividends, buybacks, and mergers and acquisitions. It wasn't invested in R&D and software and things that would help improve the...
I don't think we really know that. What we know is that a lot of it was used to buy back shares. But what did the shareholder do with the money that he got when his shares were bought back? He bought some other shares. Maybe he bought shares in startup companies. So, in fact, the money stayed in the economy and got invested rather than leading to increases in consumer spending.
Now, you're a conservative economist. You worked in the Reagan administration, so you've been through this before. One of the big concerns then was the fact that big tax cuts, unless they were offset, would increase the deficit. You guys made it revenue neutral, but they're not talking about that in Washington this year.
They're not talking about making it fully revenue neutral, but I think in order to get it passed through the Senate, they're going to have to use so-called reconciliation. And that means that any increase in the deficit has to stop within 10 years, so that anything after 10 years, those deficits can't be any larger than they're currently projected to be. And it looks like as part of the budget legislation, they're going to put an increase limit on the amount to which the budget deficit can increase during these 10 years of about 0.5% of GDP. I shouldn't have said that, 5% of GDP. So we're at 71% now. If there's no legislative change, according to the Congressional Budget Office, we're heading to 91. If they don't do anything better than this, we're heading to 96. I don't like that at all, but I don't want to give up the opportunity to improve our tax system for corporations, both in the U.S. and the subsidiaries of American corporations abroad.